What's up, guys? This is going to be a video about building Youmuu's second versus building Duskblade's second. So, before going into everything in the spreadsheet, you should keep in mind that the red headers, such as Shaco level, lethality, armor penetration, these are just the titles of the situations, and the yellow boxes, which are going to be highlights, are going to be the information that we need to fill out. The armor penetration is the green highlight, for example, where we're going to get information back based on what we fill in. And at the end, we're going to be figuring out how much damage we're going to do and what that trade-off in damage is if we do decide to build Youmuu's instead of Duskblade. So the trade-off damage is going to be based on the standard Shaco burst combo that I always use, which is Q in on top of them, Alt, U auto with a backstab, your clone autos, Tiamat E. That's a standard burst Shaco combo. So jumping right into it, I'm going to be running through the example that I use based on the runes and, you know, spells that I run. And that's going to give you an indicator of maybe, you know, what I do relative to you guys, or a general sense of what Youmuu's looks like if you do decide to run it second. So we have to input a little bit of information here. So Shaco level is obviously going to be relative to the game timer. But if we think about when you generally have your three items, the three items that I build are Tiamat, Mobility Boots, and Youmuu's. I know a lot of people cycle between that and Zerkers and Duskblade. So if I'm going to be getting those three items, I can be at, you know, somewhere between a very early level 8 or a level 12. So I'm just going to put 10 here just to, you know, for example. The lethality that we're going to get only comes from two parts. The first part we can get lethality from is the Youmuu's. The Youmuu's gives us a flat 18 amount of lethality. The second place where we can get lethality is Sudden Impact. Sudden Impact gives us 10 lethality. So over here, whether or not you're building Youmuu's or Duskblade, because they both give 18 lethality, we're going to be putting 28 over here. When we put 28 over here, we get the number back armor penetration. Armor penetration is going to be the actual stat that matters because lethality translates to armor penetration. The ratio of armor penetration is going to be the amount of lethality that you have multiplied by the level you are divided by the total amount of levels, which is level 18. So in this case, 28 lethality translates into roughly 15.5 repeating armor penetration. None of that matters without an example to test on. The armor of the target matters just as much as the amount of lethality that you have. So in this case, we're going to run through a standard example of running through Jin. If we use Jin and we set Jin at the same level at level 10, and we find that Jin gives us, or Jin roughly has 56.1 armor without taking any other type of, you know, rune or cloth armor into type of build. So this is just the base example of what we're going to go to. Now this gives us true armor. True armor is the actual amount of effective armor someone has after you subtracted your armor penetration from their target. So what I do is I take D3, armor of target, subtracted from C3, armor penetration, and I get his effective armor, 40.54 repeating. Now this is going to give us our damage multiplier, which is the most important part. Because the damage multiplier is the amount of actual damage that you do. If I have 180, and I auto-attack, I'm not going to do 100 damage. I'm going to do 100 modified by some number based on the amount of armor available. And that amount is 100 divided by 100 plus the amount of true armor that that person has. So in this case, 40.54. So in terms of 80, we're going to be multiplying it by this. And you see this over here. 80 before, so this is where all our 80 sources that we're going to get to are. And we're going to multiply that H3 by the multiplier. So in this case, if we had 11.880, it actually only translates into 59.55 damage when you auto-attack them for health. Next, we have to fill in a couple of extra things. So we have to fill in the deceive level. These days, I'm maxing deceive first to level 5. So because I'm maxing it to 5, we have to figure out how much damage we're getting from the deceive, right? So we're getting 10 per level plus 40% bonus AD. So here we have 10 per level. It's 10 times A6, which is a level, times 40% H5. H5 is our bonus AD. Our bonus AD is based on all these variables that we haven't filled out yet, so we're going to get back to it. Our two-shift poison level, well, if we have 5 points in Deceive, 1 point in W, 1 point in Alt, we have 3 points left if we're level 10 on Shaco. So I'm going to just substitute in 3 over here. If I'm substituting 3 in here for two-shift poison, then I'm going to get the 55 plus 25 per level plus 60% plus 0.15 per level bonus AD. So here you have the flat 55 plus the 25 per level. Remember, we have to subtract one here because let's say we, you know, C6, let's say if we put 5 here, we don't want them stacking on top of each other. It's not 25 times 5, it's 25 times 4. So because it's the difference between each level, you know, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5. So subtracting one plus the 0.6 ratio, and then we're doing the same thing. We're getting 0.15 per level C6 minus 1 multiplied by the bonus 80. Now here you see that I'm using this number instead of this number, bonus 80 before to bonus 80 after. I'll explain that a little more when we get to celerity. And then we have to fill in some standard numbers. Tiamat AD, right? The amount of AD that we have from Tiamat is 25. It's stagnant. The amount of AD that we have from Youmuu's or Duskblade, it's stagnant. 55 here and 55 here, right? So we're filling this in as 55. Here we're filling out either a 0 or a 1 as a dummy variable to see if we have Duskblade. You can see that at the end we have this whole lump here, which is C9, which is 0, haha, multiplied by 30 plus 10 times A3. So what this means is that we have to factor in the Duskblade Night Stalker damage. So it's 30 plus 10 per level. So when we have 30 times 10 per level, this is the amount of our Duskblade Night Stalker damage. In this case, we're putting it at 0, so since we're not running Duskblade, since we're running Youmuu's. And then we have to estimate the amount of eyeball collection. So when we think about eyeball collection, we have to think about how many eyeballs are we going to have. It's 0.6 per eyeball for AD. So if we get 2 from each champion kill and 1 from each champion assist or war takedown, up to 20. We don't know how many we're going to have in like a 15 to 20 minute game. It's probably closer to 15 or 20, but just because the we want an example, we'll just put 10 here. Now here's where, depending on what you run. So I don't run Absolute Focus right now or Water Walking, and I do run Celerity and Gathering Storm. So I'm going to put a 1 here for Celerity, 0 or 1, depending on whether or not I take it. So because we run Celerity, and because there's a difference in the amount of move speed that we're going to have at different points in time in our combo, we have to measure the amount of move speed that we have differently. What I mean by that is, when you run Youmuu's, you get 40 move speed out of combat, and that's going to change after your first auto attack. So if we're going to go on them, Q on them, ult, auto, Tiamat E, the out of move speed combat only is going to exist for our first auto attack. Same thing for mobility boots, right? If we're going to run mobility boots, then we're going to only have, we're going to have 140 together on our first auto, but we're only going to have the additional 25 from mobility boots after the first auto. So this is where we separate 80 before from 80 after. So I'm going to give you an example. So Shaco has a base of 350 move speed right here. 350 plus the mobility boots, which is 25 plus 115, so that's 140. So 350 plus 140 is 490. Plus we're going to get the Youmuu's 40, so that's 530. And then we're going to multiply that all by 20%, because we're going to get 20% move speed on top of that, right? So that's going to give us 1.2, or that's going to give us 530. And over here, we're going to multiply it by 1.23. So what I mean by here is, since move speed is additive, we're going to take this 20% move speed that we get, and then we're going to add that to the 3% move speed that we get from Celerity. So when we multiply the amount of move speed that we have, multiply by 1.23, this is the amount of move speed that we actually have in our first auto attack. But this is going to be dramatically different than the amount of move speed that we have after our first auto attack. So after our first auto attack, we're going to have the 350 from Shaco, plus only the 25. So that's going to be 375. So it's going to be 375. But we're also going to multiply that by 1.23, because remember, we still get the 20% from the Youmuu's active, and we still get the 3% from Celerity. So when we do this, we see a dramatic amount of move speed difference, which translates into a reasonable amount of AD difference, right? So when you have all of this in here, it roughly translates to 229 AD, but Celerity is giving us Celerity with move speed from the Youmuu's and the mobility boots out of combat is giving us roughly 1080 that is in our first hit, that you can all see from these parts. Obviously, we're not running Absolute Focus, we're not running Water Walking, and let's say it's 15 to 18 minutes in the game, then the amount we're getting from Gathering Storm is only going to be 4.8. So we're going to enter 4.8 over here. So now we filled out all our variables. So let's see what that translates into. So if you're looking at all of this and you want to make sure to double check my work, it's 66, which is the base amount of Shaco's 80, plus 3.5 per level over here, plus 3.5 per level, plus A9, which is the Tiamat bonus 80, plus Youmuu's, which is the bonus 80, plus 0.6 for eyeball, plus So this is just the amount of AD plus A15. So celerity is on, multiplied by C15. So this is the first auto. Remember, this is AD before, plus B18, which is 0, plus B21, which is 0 here, plus A24, which is the Gathering Storm 4.8, plus 10.8, which is the base amount you get from running Domination with Sorcery, 10.8. So when you have all this, this is the amount of AD that you have. Now, 233.89 AD. If you're having that much AD, you have to keep in mind how much that actually translates to when you're auto-attacking someone, right? Remember, we multiply it by the damage multiplier. So if we have 233.89 AD, or 234 AD, that, and we hit someone, we're only going to be roughly doing 166 damage to, you know, the Jhin target that we talked about. And this is just bonus AD. It's basically everything I repeated, but I took out the Shaco and the Shaco bonus per level to make it easier to put this cell H5 into over here for deceive damage. So deceive is going to do that much. And everything down here is the same. It's just with this changed, E15, which is the out of movement combat speed dropped. You know, so we see we drop like 980 after our first hit. We drop like 6 effect. We drop 7 effective true AD after our first hit, and then our bonus AD drops like, 9. And then obviously we do the same thing over here. So when we think about how much damage this combo is doing coming out from the build that I'm running, we're roughly doing 640 damage. So if I write down Tiamat, Mobi, Youmuu with Celerity, Gathering, is going to do roughly 640 damage. Now we have to compare how much damage does that do in a burst combo to some of the alternatives that we would have ran. So let's say, for example, we run Celerity and Water Walking, right? If we run Water Walking and we're level 10, then we already see that Water Walking is going to give us, 3 plus 18 per level. This translates to 10. If you guys don't trust me, I'll click on it for you. This is 10. 10 at level 10. So if we substitute all of that out and run this, then, the difference between Tiamat, Mobi, Youmuu, Celerity, Water Walking is going to be, 655 damage. You're getting roughly 15 more damage in your burst combo if you're running Celerity to Gathering Storm before Gathering Storm hits the second point, which makes sense. So let's do it with Duskblade because, you guys are going to wonder, is it better to build Youmuu second? Is it better to build Duskblade second? So all that we're really changing here is we're changing this to 1. And that's it. Well, we have to change the move speed, right? Because now we're not getting the move speed from the Ghostblade. So if you're going to run, let's say, Tiamat, Mobi, Dusk, Celerity, Water, for example, then you're going to put a 1 here for Duskblade damage. How much move speed are you going to have? You're going to have the 350 flat plus the mobility boots, which is going to be the put you to 490. Right, and then no out of combat moves. So this is gonna be 490, but you have to change this number. So this is gonna become 103 because you're not getting that extra 20% from the Youmuu's active. You're only getting the 3% from Celerity. And then we're gonna drop off the 115 from mobility boots after your first hit. So this is gonna be 375. The 350 flat from Shaco plus the 25 from mobility flat from mobility boots. And after you change this, so this is what it looks like if you're running Tiamat, Mobi, Duskblade, Celerity, Water. You're going to be doing 778 damage, which is, reasonable. It's like 130 damage, 140 damage higher if you run Duskblade compared to Mobius. I know some of you are going to ask, what if you run Zerkers? So I'll do that for you. Zerker, Duskblade, Celerity. I'm just covering some of the more popular options, right? So if you're running Tiamat, Zerker, Duskblade, Celerity, Water, then you're changing the move speed numbers, right? So if you're running Zerker, you're getting 45 flat instead of the 25 flat. So now you're just doing the 350 plus the 45, which is 395, right? That's all you have. You're going to get 395, and it's going to be stagnant for the entire duration. So 395, 395 with Duskblade. And if you're running this type of a combo, you're doing 776 damage. So basically, this is what you're looking at. Now, you might have some variation that you run on your own. You might not even run Sorcery Second, and I think you're making a mistake if you're doing that anyway. But point being that the build that I'm running in a burst situation is going to give me roughly 100 to 30 to 140 less damage in a burst instance at the 2-item spike, 3-item spike if you count boots, for the trade-off of having Youmuus, right? Obviously, you have to look at how much you care about Youmuus. I care about Youmuus way more than I care about Duskblade, because I value the out-of-combat move speed and the active move speed way more than I value the additional 130 to 140 damage, because I don't think I'm going to be able to kill them anyway. I can't one-shot them yet, right? It's too early in the game for me to one-shot them. I need 3 items before I can one-shot them. So I can only kill someone if that target's, you know, going to die anyway because they don't have flash, or because they're already low, in which case Youmuus gets me there anyway since they're really, really low. So because I view the world in that way, I don't care about the ability to clear the wards as much or the additional damage, because I don't think that additional damage matters as much. But if you are a player that cares about that additional damage and you care about this 130 damage that you see in the differential here, then by all means, go for it. So this was just an overview on Youmuus versus Duskblade. Basically, what it boils down to is, are you willing to trade off the move speed benefits from Youmuus for 130 to 150 damage, 130 to 140 damage? If yes, build Youmuus. If not, build Duskblade. That's it. If you're building Zerkers, that's just a preferential build. You can see that the difference between Zerkers and Mobis is minimal in the Duskblade situation, so it's just a boots preference. 2 damage doesn't really matter. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoy this content, if you enjoy this type of analysis, feel free to follow and do all that good stuff. And I will see you guys next time.